yet he set my feet. And establish my God. And I love the third verse, because when God brings you out of something, he don't just establish you going, but he gives you a new song. Y'all can come to heaven to share. Your song might not be my song. One of my songs gonna be "I'm So Glad Trouble Don't Last All Day." That identified with what I've been going through, but God will give you a new song. Somebody else's song might be "My Soul Look Back and Wonder How I Got Here." Somebody else's song might be "I Got a Feeling Everything Is Going to Be All Right." Gives you a new song. Amen. What I love about God, when he gives you a new song, can't nobody sing it like you. Amen. Because it identifies with what you've been going through. Amen. And folks will come to you and say, "I never heard you sing that song like that before." Amen. Because they don't know like you know. Amen. What he done for you. That's why I tell people, I know my way. Now, I got a problem with waiting on some of y'all, but I ain't got no problem waiting on me. The problem is when I'm waiting on folks. That's when the problem is. Y'all might not believe this, but folks sometimes don't even want to take you nowhere if you got gas. Amen. Used to be a time they'd say, "I need some gas money." Amen. Now, sometimes folks just don't want to be bothered.
No. No,
if you got gas
money. They don't.
But the text says, "I don't mind waiting on the Lord." On the Lord. I don't mind waiting. And when you're waiting on God, folks around you think, "Oh, ain't nothing gonna happen for her."
Amen.
They don't realize why they talking. God already working some things out for you.
Amen.
God will have your ears where you won't even, it won't even, he'll have your ears when you don't pay stuff like that, don't you?
Amen.
Don't even bother.
Amen.
God will have you blind to gossip and blind to what folks think about you. Until when you see them, you so happy to see them, they can't figure out why you happy to see them when they don't want to talk about you. You know, because God has blinded your ears, but what they say don't bother you.
Amen.
Can't nobody stop Pastor Hunter's blessing but me.
That's right. Amen.
Amen.
Can't nobody stop your blessing but you. Stay focused. Don't let what you're going through stop you from trusting in God. God gonna bless everybody in here that stays with him and stick with him. God has a blessing for you. Don't give up. I look at Brother Brooks and his family. How they come in here. How many kids y'all got? They got 6 kids, and my mother had 21, 18 living. And I look at them. And I know the enemy makes them think sometimes it's a struggle. It's really not a struggle. Y'all are rich compared to somebody sleeping up under the bridge. I don't care how trouble comes. You keep saying to yourself, we are blessed.
Amen.
So the man thinks, so is he. You keep saying, "Honey, we a blessed family. God getting ready to move us to another home. We got some doctors and lawyers in this family who raised us." To be positive things. How do you think the Jackson 5 got where they at? That father might have been hard, but he had a vision. And he had a dream. that he won't gonna let nobody stop him from getting there. You got to have a vision, and you got to have a dream. And when you got a vision and a dream, there's some of your own kinfolk, you just got to leave alone. They don't believe your vision, so what? Treat them nice and go ahead on. Y'all might not believe this, but it ain't for y'all to believe. It's for me to believe. Y'all looking at a future millionaire.
It ain't for you to believe,
but
I just
don't know.
I said it's for me.
Amen. But I just don't see it. It ain't for you to see. Amen. That's why you be seeing yourself in the same car, the same neighborhood forever until you start seeing yourself. So the man thinks of me. Stop thinking big and stop thinking low. Broke today don't mean you're going to be broke tomorrow. I refuse to die the same way I was born. I'm going to die with some money. But before I die, I want to spend as much as I can. Because all folks are going to do is fight over my stuff. I'm going to spend as much as I can. If I leave some, it's only because I didn't have enough time to spend it out. Start thinking big. Get you a dream, get you a vision, and grab a hold to it. And say, God, what is it going to take for me to get there? Does it mean I have to leave Joe alone? Does it mean that my Uncle Buck can't be come over here talking crazy no more? Does it mean, it might mean that. I don't know. I don't know. But I do know God has a blessing for all of us. It ain't meant for all of us to be poor. Somebody ought to be a millionaire just to show folks that God, listen, when God makes you a millionaire, he don't make you a millionaire. Now, let me make that straight for you. He makes you a millionaire to help somebody else. I'm going to make that plain. But at the same time, you can enjoy yourself. But God is going to make you a millionaire so when he lay on your heart and say, you know that house you just rolled past? Buy that woman a house. But you know that person just standing on the corner holding off that sign. Now, he ain't playing a con game. He really in need. He's not going to bless us just for us to hold on to ourselves. He blesses you so you can be help to somebody else. That's why God can't bless everybody. Because some folks don't know how to act and they ain't got nothing already. They ain't got nothing already, but they tried to act uppy.
Amen.
And the scripture said, when a man think of himself as something, when he is nothing, he deceives himself. You know, I hate to be around folks that deceive themselves, think they all that. You follow them home, they're junk in one room, they're junk in another room. They ain't halfway got a bed, got bricks up under their beds and such, but when you see them out in public, they think they go. We ain't coming here, man. Let's get ready quickly. Are we having communion today?
Amen.
Amen. Let's get ready to have communion. Let's get ready. Let's take up our tithes and offering quickly. We're going to get ready to get out of here. We still on good time. We normally out about 1:15.